ACL as well. This has got a chance to be a really good matchup. Tony Smith finished last season top five in the world. There you see Tony on the left and Logan Chamberlain on the right. He's a national champion on the college side. Texas A&M. First back will be by Tony Smith. It's a good start. Now what's going to be interesting about these two teams is that you're going to see a lot of bags in front of the hole. Right? They may still put them all in, but the way that they get there is usually not going to be by sliding every single bag. And you saw a block right there at the gate. It was pushed through, kind of testing the waters in this first round, seeing how somebody's getting into a block. So this is really a feeling out period. Right there, they throw them all in, right?
That'll
be Mike's double four-bagger. And yeah, you know, sometimes that's what we see out of these top pros. I mean, they can easily slide them all in, right? Just kind of feel each other out, see where they're at, see where their head's at, see if they're right down the middle. So Mark Richards was just saying the last matchup. And then all of a sudden, we'll start to see some blocks.
Now, what is interesting about what is happening down here on this end, today was also singles day in singles bracket play, as we see an incredible roll right over the top there by Jacob Trzcienski. These two on this end played in the same bracket. They played two incredible games. One finished 21-19, one finished 21-17. They went back and forth, back and forth. He's saying Slickside push that blue bag up and in. That's going to be a big five-point round. Now, what I was saying about Smith and Trzcienski and Burton Jr. on that end is that ton of back and forth. Trzcienski at one point had a 10-point round. He forced mistakes against Burton Jr., which kept it close, but it was the rounds in which they put a lot of bags in the hole. One bag left, one bag right by Trzcienski that ultimately led Burton Jr. to winning. So I expect on that end for Trzcienski to really muddy up the board.
Justin Burton Jr. on top of everything that we've talked about. I want what you were saying. He finished just one game away from making it in the singles and doubles finals again. Flips over the hole, just stays on the board, and look at this.
Wow, and we're a couple rounds in. We're already into the media timeout, 11-0.
And right away, Justin Burton Jr. and Logan Chamberlain talking things over, down 11-0 early.
In this house, we believe anyone can play.
Junior, but it's amazing how much Logan Chamberlain has developed from when we saw him, the ACL college program on national television. He did win that national championship in the teams division, but we weren't sure if he was going to be as polished as a singles player. But obviously, he figured it out in doubles alongside Justin Burton.
Couple of rookies. Win that first national, first major of the year.
We talked about that block. Trzcienski sitting on top. Crowd getting a little antsy. They want to talk about it.
Timeout by Burton
Jr. I say just
So what everybody wants in the crowd is what they call a bar of soap. And because this bag is elevated, this red bag, if they go really hard up the center, he may get the bag in his hand and the blue bag in, and this red bag may actually get launched over the hole and either off the board or on the backside. Very, very difficult shot. Don't know if he's going to go for it because you do have to throw it a lot harder. It's an aggressive shot.
Could be a big momentum swing. Goes at it. It goes off the back of the board and
kind of half of it.
He did.
It was tough to see, but that bag did pop in the air. The problem was he only caught it on the side. He didn't hit it straight on. He hits it up and straight on with the same pace. He hits the shot.
Come on, cut.
Jake Trzcienski trying to cut around. Looking like it's wanting to walk back in. Mm-hmm.
NHL was able to catch up during the timeout with Jacob and Tony Smith talking about this big lead.
Jacob, you guys had a big lead just a couple rounds in. Did you see this happening?
Definitely not. I mean, we just got to stay focused and continue to stay straight. That's all we got to do, and I hope we can pull it through.
I saw you guys warming up back there. Did you switch bags just right before the game, or is this what you were going to throw?
We switched bags like maybe an hour ago. Just the boards are a lot faster than they were over in the other venue.
Any changes going into the next part of this match?
No, just stay straight like we always do.
Good. Thanks so much, guys.
Trey, there's so many different variables when these players throw, depending on the rooms and the temperature and the number of people that are there, the humidity. So why was it so important they changed bags here?
Yeah, well, because, like you said, the board conditions, right? Think of this as, and it's not a perfect analogy when you talk about golf to cornhole, but it's essentially a golfer getting out as we, another miss, it's going to be three more points. But, as I was saying, a golfer going onto a green and measuring and seeing, the greens are playing really fast today, they're playing really slow, right? A golfer may adjust their trajectory of their shot. Cornhole players can do that as well, but the other thing they can do is can change the bag. It'd be like if the ball that was rolling on that green, certain different types of balls would have different friction to change it, so it's just that adjustment that they can make.
Hey, Michelle, what did you see down there?
Well, what's interesting is I was talking to Jacob, and he said yesterday they threw bags that weren't even theirs because the boards were so slow. They had to go find faster bags that they'd never thrown before, but it got them here. So that's why it was interesting to see they changed to a different bag today.
So interesting. So much strategy behind the scenes that people would probably never think of in this sport of cornhole.
Roll.
Talk about all the time, the two sides of the bags. One side is sticky side, the other is really a slick side. Different bags with different speed ratings as well.
Here comes a roll bag and it just takes a little bit left. They're going to take a timeout. I don't blame him because I don't know what you want to do here.
Are you good?
What's happening?
I like how he's cutting going with it.
I don't think that's a good idea. I think it'll just fall.
You don't think sticky. Is that ball going to be good before?
Roll it, and then don't. I mean, then you don't have to worry about those going just tapping that in. You think it'll even? If you hit it?
If I hit it right, yeah, it'll go. It'll fall. If I hit it perfectly. All right,
well, let's go. Come on, get something going for me here.
Well, you heard what they're going to try to do. There's not much hold here, right? So.
Are you worried about the claw?
I am, but a roll is a safer option, right? It's better than trying to go straight at it, right? It's a con, right? It's really the same. I think when I'm down 15-0, I might have gone with the other strategy that I first talked about, maybe trying to hit that right side, see if something fell. Yes, you run the risk of other bags falling, but what you've done so far is not working. You're down 15-0. I'm more apt to take chances down 15-0. Yeah, you know, with all the crazy
shots that you hit nowadays, you and I spend a lot of time talking about risk versus reward. And I'm totally with you. If it's a 15-12 game, okay. Maybe
put it on the
one
board. Yeah.
Spins that one and pulls the string, leaves a little bit short. Locker there for Tony Smith to look at.
Locker.
Like you just said, they got to do something. Try and change it up here. Over the blocker. Oh, nice shot by Logan to clean it up.
How about that? Those back-to-back shots, right? Perfect roll. Literally bounces up in the air over the bag sitting in front. Beautiful cleanup by Chamberlain. Beautiful shots right here.
High level play.
There's one. See, there's a hop action.
It's just, his bag has so much attitude, right?
Attitude is a great word.
Junior there on the left again, 20 years old, ACL rookie. He did finish last year in the state of Texas, so it wasn't like no one had ever heard of him. Spins that last one in.
Oh yeah, can you talk to people in Texas? They're like, what are you talking about? bucket, Logan. I mean, that reaction absolutely describes the level of shot we just saw from Tony Smith. He sits behind it. He gets positioned.
I mean,
he's up in the round.
Shoot it or try to pull it in.
Either or. Now do it with confidence. Now hit. Let's go.
Shot and pull that other one in. Do it with confidence.
I say roll it, but
it's
up to you.
Shot clock ran off, so it's going to force a timeout.